All right, so what's the consensus? Is Kazuya broken beyond comprehension, or is he an exploitable heavy whose shorter range makes it challenging for him to find the openings he wants? Well, there's nothing better than a solid tournament run to showcase what Kazuya has got going for him. How's it going, Smashers? My name is Bonk, and in this video, we'll go over Axiom Excel's run at Push the Limit 12. In case you didn't know, Axiom Excel recently took second place at a stacked tournament, possibly one of Kazuya's best placements, considering not only how new he is, but also how competitive the bracket was. Now, if you're trying to pull off some similar results, you'll want to head over to ProGuides.com, where we have a ton of courses as well as coaches who can help you level up your game. Jumping into it, let's begin with Loser Semis, Axiom Excel versus Nido Sharp. Axiom Excel ends up running Kazuya against two of Smash's best characters, Zero Suit Samus and Joker. This set starts with an explosive game one. XL finds plenty of neutral wins and manages to take the first stock with a high percent reversal. To be honest, it looks like he's playing to survive, and his up special coincidentally ends up killing ZSS at 154%. But this establishes a fact you need to be aware of. Kazuya's up special is a strong kill move. Working on Sharp's second stock, Axiom Excel is able to rack up an insane 74% damage after only 3 neutral wins. This sets him up, and after comboing an electric into an up special, he takes the second stock. By the way, just to save some time, we'll refer to Electric Wind Godfist as Electric throughout the video to differentiate its weaker variant, Wind God's Fist. It's after this stock that Sharp starts playing safer, choosing to approach with options like Spaced Zair. This is a common strategy players are using against Kazuya. Walling him off with spaced aerials is usually a good choice because he needs to get close if he wants to do those nasty combos we've all seen on Twitter. Eventually, XL does take the first game, using Electric to confirm into up air. Game 2, Sharp switches to Joker to mix things up. While the start is rough, XL beautifully demonstrates Kazuya's insane advantage state off of a single grab. This leads to a series of strings that ends with him finishing the stock, taking nearly no additional damage. Although this showed Kazuya's ability to thrive off of a single win in neutral, this same game also showed how rough it is playing Kazuya in disadvantage because of his limited landing options, fall speed, and weight. In spite of an 83% lead at last stock, he has trouble closing out the game and isn't able to find the opening he wants. Like the previous game, Kazuya's short range is exploited. He gets comboed hard after losing a few neutral exchanges and ultimately loses, unable to safely return to stage. Game 3 plays out in a similar fashion, but cuts close, with Sharp winning off a back air. Game 4, XL knows he needs to win the next two games in order to stay in the tournament. As the first stock plays out, what's crazy is that XL manages to get his rage drive while holding his shield, leading to a kill rather than a punish. This was because he got hit by Aegon earlier, and the damage over time pushed him past the 100% mark while he was holding shield. He rolls with this momentum, taking a second stock a minute later. The lead really adds up, and XL takes the game with an up special later on. Again, Game 5 cuts it close. After the players trade stocks, XL nearly gets a zero to death off a single grab. Ironically, a pivotal moment of this game is when Sharp chooses to camp out XL, understandably so since he's at such a high percentage. He racks up solid damage with Gun from a distance, but this unexpectedly backfires because, once again, he pushes Kazuya over 100%, activating Rage Drive. A bit later, the punish comes. XL uses the Rage Drive to pick up the kill. The last stock is intense, as both players find themselves in a last hit situation. XL wins the game off of a beautiful parry followed by a grab. This is especially impressive considering the risk as well as the fact that it was against Arsene back air, which typically goes unpunished. Following this close set, we'll move on to Loser's Finals, where he takes on Mars. If his last set demonstrated anything, it's that XL is more than comfortable in the ZSS matchup. XL starts game 1 off flawlessly, tacking on 110% before taking a single hit in return. Mars fights back and manages to knock XL off stage. As XL struggles to get back onto stage, Mars is able to exploit Kazuya's weakness and keep Kazuya in disadvantage. The fact that Kazuya's recovery is mostly vertical makes it easier to keep him off stage, and the fact that he's quite tall only adds to this. While ZSS's aerials usually require a degree of precision to hit, Mars has no trouble constantly catching recoveries as well as landings. In spite of this, XL is able to take the first stock with an up air. This was close, and it's tough to determine whether he was able to dodge Mars's back air, or if the leg intangibility on the move bailed him out. Regardless, the decision was good, and he earns himself the first stock of the set. Mars quickly retaliates by taking a stock himself. The next 2 minutes go rather slow. The two take trades in neutral and eventually find themselves at last stock. It's when the two players get closer and closer to the last hit that again, we see spaced attacks and a ton of non-committal options. Mars looks for stray neutral wins, doing his best to make sure he doesn't give out a single opening. XL finds himself off stage and struggles heavily to reset back to neutral. Mars closes the game out with a solid juggle and a final up air to kill XL off the top. Landing with Kazuya is definitely tricky, especially against an opponent that can punish you heavily while staying far away from a landing down air. Moving on, we have Game 2. Mars starts off strong and intelligently wins a few neutral exchanges. As XL returns to stage, he aggressively challenges using a forward air to break out of disadvantage. He lands the hit on Mars, makes it back to stage, and proceeds to do typical Kazuya things. While Mars does get him off stage, XL challenges again with forward air and fights his way back to the stage. Shortly after, he lands an electric and confirms up smash off of it for the first stock. An adaptation XL has made in Game 2 is to mix up his recovery. Not only do we see him challenging with forward air more, he also shows just how low Kazuya can go. Again, Kazuya's vertical recovery is quite impressive, and he chooses to go super low and air dodge back to stage. Another mix-up we see is when he chooses to use Heaven's Door to armor through Mars's edgeguard. While Kazuya's recovery isn't bad, it is linear. Most of the time, his best bet is to go upwards. His horizontal recovery is weaker because of his side special's range as well as his slow airspeed. He's tied with Byleth for 10th slowest in the game. In spite of this, the change of pace from Game 1 to Game 2 demonstrates how important it is to throw in aggressive recovery options. Kazuya players have to make their opponents second-guess their edgeguard attempts. Although you could consider this a fundamental, there are many characters with strong enough recoveries that timing mix-ups are all you need to get back to ledge. Moving forward, let's talk about the final stock of this game. XL takes the game with an up B out of shield. Don't get me wrong, this isn't a godlike frame 3 get out of jail free card like Game & Watch's. It is, however, an okay one, coming out at frame 12. More importantly, it's a solid anti-air you can use to call out opponents trying to land on your shield with an aerial. What's crucial about this move is that it kills. At high percents, you can turn your body into a lethal hitbox. While it's not safe on shield, the attack gives you room to drift around as a mix-up, and more importantly, it doesn't put you into freefall. You can throw out other attacks while trying to land. Next, we'll run through Game 3 of this set. Off the rip, XL fidgets around with several crouch dashes, applying a ton of pressure. Shortly after, XL lands an electric and starts racking up decent damage. He lands a second one shortly after, and amidst a chaotic mix-up, Mars breaks out of disadvantage with ZSS's frame 1 jab. Mars gradually picks up a lead and knocks XL off stage. It gets dangerously close, but XL recovers in this situation by going extremely low, then using Kazuya's impressive vertical coverage. Fighting for center stage, XL powers through with his command grab, killing Mars with Rage Drive. The early kill at 65% is insane, and the fact that the option has armor is pretty powerful. Although players naturally want to wall out Kazuya, it can be risky, especially when he has his Rage Drive. Brute Force isn't typically the wisest choice, but in Kazuya's case, it's a viable way to call out aggressive opponents. XL takes Mars' second stock with a parry into F-Tilt, killing from center stage at 117. The following sequence is another demonstration of Kazuya's incredible advantage state. Electric Wind Godfist has disgusting hit stun, and any follow-up puts enemies in a rough spot. XL tacks on some serious damage afterwards. Like Game 2, XL does win Game 3 using his up special, however in this case he combos into it. Game 4 is next. Things look rough at the start. Mars is safely dealing damage and XL isn't able to get in. After taking 84% of damage, XL finally finds his opening. In a matter of seconds, he's able to deal serious damage with a Wind God Fist. Following this, he manages to land a command grab by prematurely ending his jab combo. XL takes the first stock of this game with a very well-played bait. While near kill percent, he empty lands on Mars' shield and rolls through him. Mars misses the up B out of shield as a result, and XL is able to use electric and combo into an up smash. Following this, he's doing whatever he can to get extra credit. He eventually finds his opening and manages to get 54% off a single catch. Slowly, he racks up more damage and XL once again takes a stock with up special. XL once again manages to find an opening on Mars' last stock and nearly ends the game off of it. 71% is good enough though, and after a couple more neutral wins, Mars is at kill percent. XL picks up a kill with up special, winning the set against Mars 3-1. Axiom XL ended up taking second place at this tournament. The win over Mars was especially impressive. He demonstrated how powerful Kazuya's advantage state is, and also showed that his recovery isn't as weak as people perceived. That said, we do need to talk about his weaknesses a bit more, so let's talk about what Light did right to end XL's run. The final set we'll go over is versus Light. Game 1 is just absolute destruction. Light finds a quick 3-stock, but it's important to look at why he's able to find much more success than previous opponents. The major difference is that Light is finding a lot more out of juggles. To reiterate, Kazuya has very few landing options to work with. While XL does find an early grab, Light manages to get back to ledge. Then, Light goes for an aggressive ledge drop fair to get back on stage. He follows XL's drift and proceeds to hit him with several up airs to keep him in disadvantage. After punishing a whiff to take the first stock, Light does it all again on the second stock. Light manages to land a dash attack, launching XL into the air. He takes his time, lands an up air, and attempts to catch the down air landing afterwards. And he does. Sort of. He F smashes, ending up behind Kazuya because he had armor while attempting to command grab him. After exhausting the rage drive, Light picks up the second stock with a back air, and the third stock shortly after by gimping with forward air. Game 2 should have been a solid start for XL, since Light SD'd his first stock away. After getting off of the respawn platform, however, XL is suddenly in trouble because it's up air time. After getting more than 90% off of this string, Light secures the first stock with a dash attack into up air. XL does manage to take Light's second stock by racking up percent with a side B combo and finishing the job with an up B out of shield a bit later. On his last stock, Light manages to rack up 100% in less than 20 seconds. He does this with a variety of true combos, reads, and even an up air frame trap. He's close to taking the stock off of this sequence, but ends up eating a rage drive grab after XL shields Light's up smash. XL gets greedy though, and Light up smashes him after blocking Kazuya's F smash. While Light is close to death several times on his last stock, XL chooses not to go off stage. Kazuya definitely does struggle to edgeguard, and he doesn't have very many options to work with aside from his neutral special. Light also does a good job of punishing XL's eagerness to finish stocks with up special. He makes the choice to run up and hold shield, and XL takes the bait, using his up special in hopes of winning the game. The punish afterwards is disgusting, and Light eventually takes the win with an up smash following some footsies. Game 3 is a fast victory for XL. He manages to land some sick strings to take early stocks. XL does manage to quickly end the game in a minute and a half with a command grab. In Game 4, Light gets a lot out of every single opening he finds. He finds a dash attack and manages to get 70% off the string that follows. After another stray hit, XL is at 90%, and Light takes the first stock by landing a down air followed by a tech chase into up smash. Although XL nearly takes Light's first stock with an up special, Light has good DI and manages to survive. Upon landing, Light combos dash attack out of down air and follows up with some more up airs. It turns out that even if he chooses to air dodge, XL is left vulnerable to a frame trap. Shortly after a massive string, Light finds the kill with an up smash. In spite of getting close to making a comeback, Light's lead proves to be too much, and he ends the game by edgeguarding with Shine. There's no doubt that a big part of why Light was able to take this decisive win was the matchup. Fox's ability to fall quickly allows him to easily juggle and frame trap Kazuya. Kazuya's heavy weight and big body also make him easy for Fox to combo. Nevertheless, Light abuses Kazuya's poor landing options in this set. XL is stuck in disadvantage the majority of the time, and Light's oppressive rushdown proves to be difficult to deal with. That'll wrap up the breakdown of Axiom XL's second place run at Push the Limit 12. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you thought in the comments below. Do you think Kazuya is broken, or do you think he's overhyped? This is something I'd love to discuss, so make sure you share your thoughts with us as well. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in our next video.